Hello everyone, in this video, we will be learning how to sew a button. Sewing a button is very easy once you get the hang of it. It is a very useful skill to possess as buttons do fall off. Choose your button and thread. Select a suitable button and thread that matches the button, the garment, and any thread used to sew on other buttons. If you like, you can double the thread to make this job quicker. Then, thread the needle. Simply put the thread through the needle so that there is an equal length of thread extending from both sides. Then tie a knot at the end of the thread. One way to tie a knot is to wrap the thread around your finger. Roll the thread between your fingers and pull it tight. If you double the thread, tie the ends together. Leave a long tail of thread, whether you are doubling the thread or using single thread to sew the button. Position the button on the fabric. Line the button up with the other buttons on the garment. Also check the button hole. Close the opposite flap or panel where you want it and make sure that the button lines up with the button hole. Push the threaded needle up through the fabric and through the hole in the button. Pull the thread all the way through one each stitch. Then restart the process. Bring the needle up through the first hole again and pull the thread all the way through the fabric. Then strengthen the button. Repeat the sewing process enough times to make sure that the button is securely in place. On the last stitch, push the needle through the material but do not through the hole in the button. The humble hand sewn buttonhole is a shining example of how a hand stitch process can still be valued in the world of machines. In today's world of technology and computerization, it is refreshing to know that some handcrafts are still valued. There are many occasions when sewing a buttonhole by hand is just the better option. Step 1. Mark your position. Prepare your fabric and measure and mark your buttonhole position. This means using the actual button to mark the distance and checking how many buttonholes you will need. In the preparation, decide on whether you will sew a horizontal or vertical buttonhole. This could be specified in the pattern on your own personal choice. Step 2. Outline stitch. Choose a contrasting thread to run a row of small running stitches around the edge of the buttonhole before you cut. Step 3. Cut your buttonhole and mark the ends with a straight pin. Now start stitching using your buttonhole stitch. Insert the needle for buttonhole stitch from the top to the cut edge. Wrap the thread around the needle at the bottom, going under the tip of the needle to make the buttonhole stitch. When you pull your thread through, there should be a little knot at the top on the cut edge. This is sometimes referred to as the purl stitch and gives a nice ridge to the knitted buttonhole. When your little work of art is completed, you will be proud of the time and effort it took. Buttonholes sewn by hand on coats and jackets have stood the test of time. Now you can proudly go out and button up your overcoat. When the wind is free, take good care of yourselves, because you belong to somebody. As Martha Stewart said, buttons are the fossils of the sartorial world, and during long past the garments, they were designed to hold together.